That was a really slow intro. I just wanted to hear James be a little bit, honestly.
It's got me kind of sad.
Yeah, it's kind of sad. That kind of sets the tone for this podcast. But anyway, welcome back, my fellow jabronis. Also, we just saw on something. Was it Complex?
No, that was Sports Illustrated.
Sports Illustrated just announced that Jabroni.
Yeah, I'll read it off.
He's going to read it off. Jabroni is now officially a word in the dictionary. So, y'all that have been fucking sleeping on us.
So, yeah, The Rock. Shout out to our Lord and Savior, The Rock.
The Rock. The God.
Dwayne The Rock Johnson. He got Jabroni officially put in the dictionary. So, starts off slang, a stupid, foolish, or contemptible person, a loser. So in context, facts. She always has a comeback to own the trolls and jabronis on Twitter. Shut your mouth, you dumb jabroni. That's us, baby.
That's us. That's the jabronis. That's the jabronis. Y'all that have been sleeping on us, we're coming up. We're official now.
We're in the dictionary.
We are literally in the dictionary, minus the word podcast. But anywho, welcome back to episode 10. Finally, a fucking double
digit.
That
big double digit
number.
Big
double digit.
We're here.
We're celebrating.
Yeah.
But
champagne, baby.
Today we are going to be talking about. We asked again another poll on our Instagram to kind of see what you guys wanted to hear, and we got the feedback of embarrassing stories and also some scenty stuff. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna lead a little bit into the embarrassing. I got a fucking hilarious story that I literally just thought about like 5 minutes ago. It's gonna be fucking sick. Nick's got one too, but honestly, like, it's only been a week, but for me, every time it feels like a month. But
fucking gross.
Sorry. Shout out. Oh, I didn't bring the tub up. Fuck. I was trying to shout out.
It's AMRAP. We'll like Photoshop it in.
We'll just
sponsored.
We're sipping on some AMRAP right now. Great BCA. I think it was honestly our favorite. It was my favorite BCA.
Yeah, the it's officially called Blue Freeze, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. One of the most underrated flavors of BCAAs ever. Like, super fire.
Yeah.
Very refreshing, very
it's
crisp,
extremely,
smooth
it
flavor.
It literally tastes like Kool-Aid. It's like the best BCA.
It does. It doesn't stain your mouth either. It's not like super sugary or sweet. It's just like this very nice, crisp.
Yeah. Shout out Beyond Yourself. I work with them fairly closely now. I'm going to be doing some work with them. So they were generous enough to send over some product to me and to take some pictures and do some content for them. And I get to use it now too. And I've honestly loved Beyond Yourself from the very start. I think everyone kind of knew that. I was a very big advocate on Beyond Yourself because they're very like good with all their stuff. It's very
like, good products.
Yeah, and they
great
actually,
flavor profiles too.
And they manufacture like almost like 80% of all the like supplement companies in Canada. Like they know their shit. But yeah. Anyways, so man, what a fucking week. I've been fucking like I haven't slept properly in like the past like week and a half. My eyes feel like they're bleeding because I'm looking at the computer screen for so goddamn long.
Fuck, you need to... Actually, you have, like, blue light blocker glasses, right?
They barely... I don't even know if they're blue light blockers at this point.
You need to invest in a pair, dude.
I know. I need to get some. I need to actually get some.
Your eyes are going to be so shit by the time you're 40. You're going to be, like, squinting to read.
Especially
anything.
Me, because I'm just always constantly on the computer, too.
Yeah.
But, I mean,
that's
whatever.
What I mean, yeah.
But, yeah, man. I mean, before we get into it, let's just kind of recap a week. I mean, I've had a pretty damn busy week working on some pretty exciting stuff. I'm sure this week has kind of been the same.
Chris was just here too.
Chris came back down again. I think we said that in our last podcast, but yeah, he came back, but he just actually left yesterday. So not going to be seeing his ass till I want to say end of October. I might even be going out there like on Halloween. So that'll be fun. But yeah, he's gone. That's it for now for him, me and him. I shot as much content as I could for him and that's about it. And then we linked up. You met him again when he came down to Whistler, right? After the second time or no? Did you see him again?
No, because remember I pulled up to your house literally as he was leaving.
Right.
Chris, if you're seeing this, I'm kind of pissed that you dipped out just as I was coming, but whatever.
Yeah, he was down here with his buddy. So like they had an Airbnb on Coquitlam.
Yeah.
So he was kind of just hanging out with him more. So it was probably better for me because I was shooting the whole entire week. But
yeah.
I mean, how about your week?
My week was pretty busy, actually. It was like pretty hectic with work. I got stuck doing like an overnight shift, which fucking sucks. It's sick because like you get paid to sleep there.
Yeah.
But if like the dudes aren't sleeping,
yeah,
then you're up too, right? Well, so that was the case.
The thing like, is like I got 2 hours of too, sleep. Like I have to sleep in my own bed. Like my own bed is like I'll get the best sleep. So if I sleep in a foreign bed,
yeah,
it's just not the same. It doesn't hit different. Hits different.
I agree. I mean like here's the thing. Like I'm such a huge like I can't take naps regularly. So like if I don't get a good quality of sleep when I go to bed in my own bed, like that's it. Like the quality of the sleep that I have at night is what I solely rely on to like recover and feel good.
Yeah, I know.
But like I started reading actually. Like I got back into like books.
Yeah, what the fuck were you reading? I saw your snap story. So,
I can't remember the name of the book that I'm reading right now. It's like it's something on addiction. Just like it, you know, in light of I know the 31st was National like Overdose Awareness Day or something like that.
Something like that.
But anyway, it's like a book on addiction and understanding addiction and whatnot. It was actually written by a guy who works in Vancouver. On Hastings. He's a doctor, Dr. Gabor Metis or something like that. I can't remember his name.
I
probably butchered his name, but like, you know, he's probably never gonna listen to this, so whatever. But the first book that I actually started reading, a friend lent me The Tao of Wu.
I think I've heard of that.
Sick book. And it kind of just gives like an origin story on the Wu-Tang Clan, which was like, yeah, it was like I didn't really know what to expect, like reading it, but it, I don't know, it just like the philosophies on, you know, where Wu-Tang Clan started from and how they came up with, you know, just like the era that they lived through and like where they lived was just like insane. So like, just kind of like hearing, you know, I don't know, just hearing some of the stories and, you know, seeing like the mindsets that they had to adapt to live how they did.
I mean,
pretty wild.
Their era is probably a whole lot better than 2020. That's for damn sure. Fucking also, can I just say one of my favorite superheroes, rest in peace, Chadwick Boseman.
Oh, yeah. That
holy fuck, bro. That shit made me so sad because I'm like a fucking, if anyone knows me, I am diehard fucking Marvel fan.
Yeah.
I fucking.
This guy watched Endgame how many fucking times? I watched six, seven times in theaters.
Yeah, I watched it. No, not six. I watched it 5 times. In theaters.
Wow.
So I watched like, it. Holy shit. I watched Endgame the first time in like, who did I go with? Fuck, I don't even remember who I went with. Oh, I went with Shab. Oh,
okay, yeah.
Fuck, that was, I don't know what it is. Every time, it was back then, it was always me and Shab that went to go see movies together. It was me and him.
He's a huge fan of
yeah, he likes the Marvel comics too. Right? Yeah. So like me and him, we saw Infinity War together and then we also saw Endgame together. And then my buddy, when I was working, super funny. So I was working at Lulu at the time and I got off at like, I think it was like 3 or sorry, I got off at 4. But my buddy was coming down to the High Street movie theater, the Cineplex there.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And the movie started at 3:30 and I got off at 4. Oh, so shit. I literally went up to my managers and I was like, yo, like
Endgame starts.
Can I go fucking see this shit? They're like, didn't you see it already? But I'm like, yeah, but I really want to see it again. And she was just like, okay, fine. And then I got let go. And then we went and watched it. And literally the second time it hit harder because like I almost cried.
When you knew what to expect. Yeah. But like,
and I don't give a fuck if I spoil it. It's been out for like almost a year now.
If you haven't seen it, what the fuck is wrong with you?
When fucking Tony died, dude, like that second time I watched it, it just hit way harder. Yeah. And I think it's because I saw his little daughter, Morgan Stark. And she was just, oh, fuck, I don't want to talk about it. I'm going to get fucking emotional here.
I know,
but yeah, rest in peace Chadwick Boseman. Black Panther was probably one of my favorite movies in all of, like, probably the whole entire Marvel universe. It's really sad, man. 2020 has been a fucking absolutely fucking weird fucking year, and I think we've may have said that a few times, but holy fuck, man. Like I'm optimistic and like hoping that things will get better. Like
I'm the same way.
I'm completely over this COVID stuff. I again, don't want to really dive into it and give my two cents because we probably have before, but I want things to get back to normal, and I think we are on our way. But yeah, I just honestly, I want the new year.
I'm ready for 2021, baby. Like, yeah,
I'm like,
I'm over 2020.
I don't even think like New Year's and shit is going to be the same anymore.
It's not.
I don't even think there's going to be like a New Year's thing anymore.
There's not going to be some like countdown. There's not going to be like, bro, like just thinking about like Christmas and shit almost like.
Well, Christmas is different because you can have family over stuff, right?
For sure, but like
not to an extent.
Like you know how like there was like the tree lighting and stuff, like yeah, that, like that's a big thing in Abbey. Like, you know, everybody goes down and like they do like you know, all the festivities and shit like that. It's just like, I don't know, like it just feels weird. Like everything just feels kind of disconnected.
Yeah, so. It is weird, man. Like, man, here's the worst part was like, because I've been watching the Canucks obviously play because they're in the playoffs, and it's going to be really sad if, like, I don't think we will, but I'm a diehard Canucks fan.
Yeah, you're hopeful.
But, like, if we do make the Stanley Cup playoffs and, like, there's no crowd allowed, that's going to suck, bro. Dude. The first Stanley Cup that we win again in, like, how many years? And the crowd's not even allowed to be. And, like, the thing is Vancouver, like, I get it. Like, Toronto, like, Raptors, those fans, those are diehard fans. But, like, bro, I don't think you know Vancouver Canucks fan. Like, we literally rioted Vancouver because we lost.
Was that 2011?
It was 2011.
2011.
We rioted Vancouver because we lost. So could you imagine what will happen if we won?
Bro, people are going to go fucking buck.
Yeah, like, dude, we won like a few nights ago. And people are still going down South Fraser Way.
Was Scott like Road, just crazy. Fucking just like,
yeah, dude, it brought back so much nostalgia. Did you ever fucking, like, I was always that kid, like, if the car had a sunroof, I would fucking like outside the fucking sunroof, man.
Bro, you ever like ride around in like the truck bed of a truck?
Oh, 100%. Yeah, I did that when I was a little kid too. My uncle had a truck back then, and we like hopped in the back and just fucking took off my jersey. Fuck, it's like a fucking maniac. It's like
Italy,
dude. I honestly think what's actually really like, now that I talk about it, I think, because of the limitations that we have with COVID and like how things are so different, it actually makes me fall back on like the older memories, the good times when I was like a little kid. And just like, you know, you go to like, I used to go to Canucks games a lot, and just like, you know, I used to like, I'm really gonna, because I would say winter is like that family season.
Definitely.
When you're around family a lot, it's just like homebody, fucking like, you know, you're enjoying the winter season. Like, are we just getting out of summer?
Yeah, summer's, bro, like summer's kind of been over, it feels like, but
what's the official date that winter fall starts?
Isn't it like the first week of September?
Yeah, so we're pretty much we're out of summer, because this is right now September 1st right now.
September 1st today.
So like it's, yeah, like
Bath and Body Works already has its fall shit. So
yeah, the Halloween store is already open.
There's candy and shit in the stores. I'm just so like, okay.
I'm like, all right, seasons are switching.
Ready. Yeah, ready.
Yeah, summer was gone, long gone, man.
Bro, summer was like literally like a week.
Like last week was the official last week of summer weather.
Yeah.
And I'm happy because now I don't have to fucking see a bunch of my friends' stories on Penticton and Nicole Kanagan or whatever, because I've seen
we'll
that like
see
some,
a little bit,
we'll probably still think, see it, but like, relax, dude. Go home. It's like it's fucking fall. Like, you're starting
literally,
to wear
yeah,
a jacket.
It's starting
and shit
to get cold. Like,
but yeah, this winter season is gonna be really different. I don't even fucking, dude, Halloween might not even be a thing. That's so like COVID,
bro, that's,
fucking.
That's
not
what
friendly.
I've been like trying to think of like how they're gonna play with that, because it's like, are they gonna tell like little kids to not trick or treat? Like, some kid comes to your door, what are you gonna do?
Yeah,
be
you
like,
can't
fuck
sanitize.
Off, I don't have candy. Like,
or like, you can't sanitize the candy.
How do you fix that? How do you go around that?
And that's what I'm saying, bro. I don't think there's gonna be a Halloween. Like, I generally think that BC Gov,
you would have to orchestrate, like, instead of, because you know, like all the kids just gather up in a big group and they all go to the door and everybody's all standing there and you're like tossing candy at kids and stuff, just, and it's like it's just beaming them at their heads, and it's like you're gonna have to socially distance all these kids and have like one by one single file, like,
yeah.
I don't understand how it's gonna
like
work.
I'm sure some parents will get creative, and like, I don't know, bro, it's just like, you're not gonna actually like sanitize the candy. If anything, that could be worse. Like, what if that gets into the candy and the kid eats it, you know?
Bleach just leaches into your Kit like, Kat. Just, you're just like, mommy, it tastes like under the sink.
Like the cat. Tastes like under the facts, though. Yeah, but like candies alone already have a bunch of chemicals in it, so you're just mixing you're it just with like some more like hand sanitizer or whatever the fuck. It's just like, I don't know, like maybe like, I don't know, maybe the person giving out the candy could like sanitize their hand like every time.
Yeah,
but like that, their fucking hands are gonna fall off, dude. Can you imagine that? Just like, okay, one sec. Here you go. Okay, one sec. Like at the end of the day, you're gonna have like some fucking like skin fucking you're gonna disease.
Just have calluses and stuff just ripping open on your hands, and
you're gonna turn Michael Jackson on them. Jesus. Fucking skin's just gonna fall off, bro.
Bleached skin.
But yeah, I don't know. It's I think this the season coming up. Fuck, bro. Now that I think about it, Christmas might not even happen. Well, like it'll happen. But
it's gonna
like,
be different, dude. They're gonna restrict the malls. The malls are gonna be fucking chaos because like people are gonna be trying to go in and like shop and like,
bro, buy your Christmas presents early, dude.
Buy them now.
Buy them now, man.
Go now.
Oh my god, buy your presents now, bro.
Amazon's gonna shoot up again. Jeff Bezos, what did he just clear? He cleared like he's like
$2 billion in like 3 seconds.
I can't even remember, but he reached like another milestone. But yeah, he's just going to increase his net worth more and more now.
Yo, you heard it from us first. Do your Christmas shopping now.
Today. When September 1st, start.
If COVID is still a fucking thing there, like around that time, good luck trying to go to the mall and trying to buy something. Because they're already limited on the stuff they're allowed to carry.
Yeah.
Let alone limited on people they're allowed in the store.
It's going to be super, super difficult to get any like toys or any clothing that are...
Dude, I don't even think like Black Friday and that shit's gonna happen.
No,
like the mall itself will have a occupancy limit.
Yeah,
the building, whole entire mall itself.
They already, stores do, and now the mall itself.
Have they addressed anything about that? Like the upcoming like winter Christmas season?
No, because they're probably trying to figure out what the fuck do we do. Here's my thought with like Black Friday and stuff like that. They're gonna do massive online sales. They're gonna just say don't go to stores are gonna be full regular price. We're gonna charge you more if you come in store.
Yeah,
Black Friday, just like crazy online. So that's probably what they'll do.
Honestly, the only way to kind of combat this winter season, because honestly, isn't winter season like usually when flu season comes around too?
Yeah, it's about the same time.
Fuck, bro, we're about to hit into fucking,
bro, it's gonna be like storm. This like coronavirus times 60, like
god, because we're not gonna know the difference between the two.
You know that virus from Resident Evil? It's basically gonna be that, like we're fucked. Just fucking
dude, fuck man, I was so optimistic at the start of this podcast, like I hope everything blows over and I like
just lay makes the you realize like, oh shit,
dude, yeah, we're heading into flu season, fucking, you know, Christmas shopping and all that shit. Like it is the most, like Christmas shopping and stuff, by the way, is the most like COVID prone, like fucking
that's activity where everybody can do. Gets sick. Like you got all these kids and parents and all these people just like touching doors and handles.
Touching the same present, fucking, you know, gift wrapping, like all that shit. Like they're probably not going to do any gift wrapping. Like you got to fucking, they won't. So anyone that doesn't know how to gift wrap, you're fucked. Like
go and pay your friends.
Yeah.
To
like, or just, how. Or just buy it. Just, but those stupid ugly bags that you just put the gifts in.
That's my usual go to.
But you can't do that if you're buying someone a flat screen. Just put a bag on every corner of the Merry Christmas. Or just put it in a box and just fucking color it. Which just
literally get some cardboard and just stick it in there and
yeah,
you're fuck. Good.
Man, the only way that they're gonna combat that is literally by saying stores are closed, you have to do everything online. That would honestly save them more money, because then they don't have to pay, like they would probably like let go of their staff, unfortunately, and then do everything online so they can just ship directly from their warehouse.
That's a like kind of scary thought too. Like my sister's in retail, and just having that kind of thought of,
I'm thinking
people literally all like losing their jobs because everything just gets shifted to online.
Well, I mean, dude, like I feel like, if anything, the winter season will be like our second round of COVID.
Yeah.
Like that's when it's going to happen, right? Because our cases are going back up in BC. Like we have 1,000 cases or something now.
Yeah.
But we've only had 3 deaths in the past, I don't know, month or two. And I don't even think it's related to fucking COVID, to be completely honest. So like
a heart attack.
I think the severity of the disease has gone down, but like it's just like, you know, what if we actually do hit another wave because people are just like all over the place? But
and it's like the sick, you know, the sick.
Poor kids, man. Poor kids growing up in this fucking generation and this year.
Just, dude, seeing some of those videos of kids that are trying to learn, like kids in grade one or whatever, just young kids that are trying to learn online. And somebody made it like a really good point. I think it was on Twitter or something, where they were saying how they've got a, you know, like their hearts are going out to all the young kids or grade one kids that are foreigners or their parents don't have English as a first language, and they're trying to help their kids how to do whatever schoolwork they're doing that's grade one, grade two, any of those early stages, and they're trying to learn it by themselves.
Yeah.
Bro, like
most kids are like, are schools back in session in BC?
I think so. Actually, I don't know.
I feel like they're not gonna, man. They can't, dude. We're a lot more strict with those rules too. Like we will cancel school still for, we will delay them further if we need to, if the cases are going back up. At least that's how our government has been approaching it.
It's this week, I think, right?
Yeah, it should
school,
be this week.
School should be this week.
Yeah. But anyways, speaking of kids, I got a funny kid story. Let me just go live first.
That intro was kind of sus.
It was leading in.
I got a good kid story. Talking about candy and children.
So to top off and start with our most embarrassing story for today's episode, this goes back when, first of all, it's not in a park. Thank God.
God.
It's in a gymnasium.
Just as bad. Just fucking bad.
But no. So I was really young at the time. I was like, I don't know, like 10 years old, okay. 9 years old, fucking something like that. And this is when I was like,
years ago.
Yeah. And this is when I was in, I was in karate and I was like a green belt, like very low level, you know? Right. I got dropped off at karate and we actually did karate at Chief Dan. So like, this is a long fucking time ago. And we practiced our karate there. And here's the thing. As a kid, I drank a lot of water, right? Oh, God.
I don't like where this is going.
And the thing with karate is, like, you're fighting and, like, you know, you're jumping up and down. So, like, you got a lot of movement, right?
Right.
Now, as a kid, what's the one thing a lot of kids forget to do? Go to the bathroom. So karate class is like at least like an hour and a half, right? Sometimes even two.
Yeah.
And you know,
that's,
you don't,
a long time,
you don't notice it because you're like, you're jumping around, you're running, you're fighting, yeah, like a lot, so you don't notice
your mind's
that
on something else.
Your mind's on something, you don't notice that you have to go to the bathroom. I think before karate I probably knew that I had to, but I was like, nah, I gotta fight people, you know? So I'm in karate class, right? And then I think halfway through the lesson, we don't spar anymore. So we're not running around. We're doing like stationary like poses and like standing there and not moving.
Still
like
kinda,
very still. Like, okay, we're doing like, it's called kata, which is like basically a demonstration. So it's like, it's not fast movements. It's like, well, it is fast movements, but it's, you're stationary for like 10 or 30 seconds every movement, right? So when the instructor says go, you like, you do that movement in that demonstration, then you do the next movement, blah blah blah. Now the thing is, there was one movement where you have to do like the splits, right? You have to go down to the splits and go like, and like punch, right? And like, usually when you have to go to the bathroom, the thing that helps from restraining, you fucking clench your legs, or you're like, you know, you do the little
P shuffle, where you're like, you twist your legs and you,
so
oh no,
so
it's coming out.
I'm like in this, I'm in this post, right? And this is where it hits me and I'm a little kid. I'm like,
so now you're like,
I'm like, I gotta pee. Fuck. Like, I have to pee. Like, bad. And like, the thing is like, when in karate, like, you're like, your sensei is a fucking, like, you're like, he'll like hit you and shit. Well, not hit you, but like, you know, it's discipline, right? Like, you need to, like, you can only go to the bathroom. You have to ask sensei. You have to ask him to do anything.
Right.
Go to the, get water. You have to ask. That's just tradition. Yeah. And like, when I was in karate, it was a very traditional, like, club, right? Very traditional. And I'm just, and fucking, and sensei's walking around with a fucking little bamboo stick. I'm like, fucking. And like, he tests you too. Like, you have to hold your pose really strong. So he'll like come up and like, he'll tap you on the leg or like make hit sure a little bit hard. Make sure that you're sturdy. You got to have a firm, solid foundation. Yeah. Make sure that you're like strong. And I'm, and like, the thing is, you can't like try and push and hold that and not want to pee. Right.
Oh, 100%.
So like, of course I have to go pee, but I have to ask him. Right. But he's at the fucking back of the gymnasium, and the fucking gymnasium is big.
Right.
For, and the, we had 50 students in that class.
Shit.
There's a lot of students.
And you can't just yell like, yeah, hey, I gotta just like, pee.
Hey,
like,
I have to fucking pee.
Come over and just fucking, he'll chop beat my ass. Off. Right.
So I'm standing there and I'm like, holy fuck, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. And then I'm just like, yo, this is like pushing it. Right. And he just comes up to me. I'm like, sensei, I have to go to the bathroom. He's like, just wait. I'm like, I have to go really bad, really bad. He's like, wait, just wait. I'm like, and literally, and then as literally, I'm like, oh, fuck, right? And then as literally, he's like, you can go. I was like, nope, I already let it go. And like, I'm running to the bathroom, and it's like coming out as a little kid. So,
like down your leg, you can feel it.
Yeah, and, I'm, and it's just like, here's a weird part, though, because with karate gis, they're very stiff and solid,
right?
So they don't like stick to you. They're like very like, I don't know how to, it's like you, it's kind of like wearing huge overalls,
yeah,
but the clothing doesn't touch you because it's, it feels like it's just like dried cement, like the it just like
I had a gi for judo when
yeah
I was in judo.
But judo gis are different. They're like very like baggy and they like sit.
Yeah,
karate gis are very like stiff, right?
Okay.
So while I was fucking pissing my pants as a little kid, none of the pee touched my fucking my gi.
Okay.
It was just like
sliding just down.
Sliding
your
down.
Leg.
I was like, ah! And then I go, and then I go to the little, like, you know how like back in the day it was like just the tall urinals. So it was like,
yeah,
it was like wall to floor.
Right.
So I just fucking drop my gi and just fucking just blow the fucking urinal. I'm not even aiming. I'm just like, ah,
splashing back in your face, just piss everywhere.
And then I was like, okay, I have to fucking clean my gi. And then I look at my gi, there's nothing. I'm like, huh? You know? And
like
then
you're questioning if you piss yourself.
But then I just leave this like little trail of piss. And I'm like, fuck, right? And then I'm like in there, and then I like grab a bunch of paper towel. I'm like fucking wiping it. Fuck. And then as I'm done, I throw in the fucking toilet and I flush it down. But the whole thing still smells like piss, right?
Yeah.
So I go back out and I'm just like still fucking pretending like nothing happened, even though I left like a little bit of a trail outside of the bathroom door. And out, once we finished class, we go back in, and all the other boys were just like, it smells weird. I'm just like sitting there, I'm just like,
so nobody else saw you pissing yourself?
I guess. Well, the thing is, like, when karate, like, you focus, you're actually in karate, like, when you're doing kata, you're supposed to focus on one point.
Okay,
right?
Like a
and
wall
like a lot of the
something.
Students there were very disciplined, right? So thankfully, no one actually saw me running like a little fucking idiot, like and fucking
wow.
Just yeah. So fucking that was a pretty demoralizing moment for me.
So did your sensei find out that you fucking pissed yourself?
No, he didn't.
He didn't still find out.
No, not to this day. He knows. Maybe if he watches this podcast, which is highly doubtable. He will watch this podcast, but ever since that day, no one knew that 10-year-old little Calvin in karate class fucking pee-peed in his pants, in his gi. I shouldn't even say pants, in his gi.
It was all over your gi. So,
have you ever pissed yourself as a kid?
Oh, of course.
Like, what age?
Okay, I like, there's one of the most memorable ones that I had.
Memorables? Oh, God.
I pissed myself all the time. I pissed myself last week. I was...
Oh my God! Remember that? Did we tell the story when I had to piss in the car, when on
prep? Oh my God! Yeah, yeah,
dude.
Yeah, dude.
You tell that. You tell that. You tell that.
K, Okay, we were literally driving to posing practice one day, and we had a what was it? It was a water jug in the back seat.
Yeah,
right?
I had a huge one. It was one of those big, like,
it was like the
Ocean Spray.
Yeah.
The big one.
And you had to piss so fucking bad, and you were driving, and we were already late, so there was no way that we were gonna stop. We didn't have time for that, and you're like, fuck, dude, I have to piss.
I was like thinking of so many different things, like going to pull over. Yeah.
And you're like, no, man, no, I can't do that. I'm not gonna piss in a bottle. I'm not doing that. And like, it literally got so bad. You were like, I could see forehead veins and shit.
I was like,
your eyes were pulsing, and you were like, bro, you were so
stressed.
And
we were stuck in traffic. We were stuck in traffic.
So stressed. And I was just like, okay, like, I'll just take the wheel, keep your foot on the gas and brake, and just fucking go in the bottle. And this guy literally put his dick in the fucking bottle and just pissed. And like, I don't know if I've ever like wanted to make eye contact with somebody so bad while he was doing that. Like, I just wanted to make it more awkward for you, but like, I could tell you were just like relieved but stressed at the same time.
Well,
just,
I was relieved because I was I filled the fucking shit out of that,
dude,
too.
It was like this nasty, nasty piss. Yeah. Like, it was like Trailer Park Boys.
Yeah, it was. Fuck, that was. It wasn't even. I was stressed because I thought if I had to brake.
Oh. Oh yeah, if you had to brake.
If I had to brake and I had to brake, well, not even that. If I had to brake, all the water would come back up,
splash back on your,
splash back all over me. I'm like, ah, fuck. But luckily, didn't miss a drop.
Yeah, you got it all in there.
Got it all in there. I mean, fucking, it was a. I was actually scared I was gonna overflow it because I had to. I was going for like a solid 10 seconds.
You drank a lot of water. That thing.
Oh yeah,
like
we were water
full,
loading.
Dude, that thing was pretty full.
Oh,
but
fuck.
No, mine was probably like when I was, I want to say I was probably like 8 or 9, and all the birthdays that I had, or like that we had, like we would always do like family functions at my house when I was little, and I would have all my cousins and stuff come over, and my one cousin Mike, I don't know if he watches this, but he's a tattoo artist now. He's the guy who did all my work on my arm, but he's always just been a really, really funny guy. Like, he just says funny shit that just makes me just cackle.
Wait,
and
on.
What?
I feel like I know where this is going.
Oh, dude. I, like, obviously, same kind of thing. You're a little kid. Like, you drink water. Like, you just fill up on liquids, and you're never aware of when you have to piss until it's basically dripping out of you. And then you're like, oh, no, I gotta pee. So we were downstairs playing, like, I don't know. We were playing, like, I was playing with toys or something, and like he was just telling me some funny ass stories and just saying stupid shit, and he just kept going, and I was laughing, and I kept on laughing, and then I was like, oh no, okay, I have to pee, and I felt it, and then I had to like secure myself a little bit, and then instead of being like, okay, I gotta go to the bathroom, like, I was like, no, I don't want to miss my cousin's funny stories. So I just sat there and just listened, laughing, and then I just started pissing all over myself. And I just sat there, just like, it's already coming out, like, what am I gonna do? I'm just gonna sit here in my own warm, hot piss, and I just let it roll down my jeans. My little jeans, these little fucking Levi jeans or something, and you're just like soaking the whole crotch and like oozing into my butt, and like just piss everywhere. It was all over the carpet. Oh my god, dude, that was like,
fuck.
That was my most memorable piss story that I had. It's probably like 8 or 9. Okay. I was around that same age.
You're a little bit younger than me, so it's a little bit more acceptable.
I mean, still not really. I mean, when you're fully aware that you have to pee and you're going to piss yourself if you don't move, and you just decide to piss yourself.
Yeah.
There's probably something cognitively wrong.
Since
with
then,
you.
I haven't pissed my pants besides the one point where I almost pissed my pants when I was fucking with you that time in the posing practice. Yeah. That was the only time I've ever considered. I'm just, okay, fuck it. Just I give up. You win.
Yeah. I've pissed in bottles like more times than I'm like proud to admit. Like,
I mean, dude,
backseat,
like,
driving with somebody, and you've got like, you know, you're driving to Hope or something. You literally,
well, they just pull off to the side of the road, man.
I'm one of those people who, like, if I'm the only one in the vehicle who has to pee and there's a lot of other people or even just a couple other people, I don't want to be, inconsiderate and make them pull off the road from me. I'm just like, you can keep going. It's fine. I'll just pull up this little Dasani bottle and just, you know.
Dude, a Dasani bottle is not enough. That's not enough room, man. 500 mil?
So...
I'm pretty sure the average body expels like a liter of piss per pee.
That's what is a good transition into the rest of this is anytime that I've pissed in bottles, I've always like had to open the window and then pour the piss outside while we're driving and then go back and finish. And I've probably had to do it. I think the most I had to do it was 3 times. Pee, dump, pee, dump.
How the
pee,
fuck did you control the flow?
Screw it and then just hold on to it. Oh, I've trained myself to be able to like pee and stop.
You can get like a bladder infection from that.
I know, but like it's just a cool talent to have. Like I literally taught myself. I'd just start peeing and then I'd be like, okay, stop. just just look and then keep going and stop, keep going and stop and just, I don't know, being in control penis is pretty cool.
No, that's how you master the ability to vacuum. It's by like controlling your insides like that.
Yeah, just literally.
But anywho, transitioning into the next one, we're gonna talk about some scenty stuff too. But we thought we'd start off. I did not expect I was actually gonna tell a story about me and myself when I was 10 pissing myself. Neither did I thought you were too. Every time when you say that, like when you were little playing with toys, I don't know why I can't picture little. I just picture you as yourself, just like
me, just playing with a car, vroom vroom. Just me. I was a kid once.
I don't know. I feel like he's just had the same head.
It's just always been me.
I just feel like
I came out like this. Just I feel all 205 pounds me.
I just feel like you've had the same head as a kid and it's never changed. You had the same haircut, same beard.
Oh, your baby's so cute. He's got such a nice beard. You put oils in there.
Could you imagine as a little baby you came out and you just had fucking a full beard? You'd probably think sick. Like there's something wrong with you.
Oh, there would definitely be some kind of like defect with like your genes.
You're missing a few chromosomes or some sort.
Ma'am, your son has pubes already.
Ma'am, your son already circumcised himself. But to transition into the next thing, we actually want to talk about, since we're both single, but we wanted to talk about
flirting and picking up
females. Now, here's the thing. So, obviously, we used to live the club scene a little bit, right?
Yeah.
I only lived it for like what, a year or two.
Yeah.
Did you probably you didn't live it that long either, right?
It was like maybe it, like.
But like, what was the club scene to you? Was the club scene to you like Town Hall and like, or was it like DT Vancouver?
That was more the club scene. Was Vancouver, and then. For anybody who used to remember me, I used to go to raves like fairly often and like things like those little festivals and shit like that, like Faded in the Park and whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So like those were party type club event things that I would consider like. Yeah, I used to be a pretty big shithead.
But you used to go to these festivals and stuff with like a bunch of buddies, right?
Yeah, it would just be a huge crew of people.
Yeah. So like when I went out, it was usually 9 times out of 10, it usually was my buddy Sonny, which by the way, happy birthday, Sonny. That was your birthday happy yesterday. Birthday. I used to always usually go with him or like a few group of other friends. And we would usually do the typical club hop. So we would start at like, I don't know, somewhere like, what's it called? Republic?
Yep.
It's called Republic now, right? I don't know why I wanted to call it Wet Republic, but that's Vegas. Republic, and then we would go from Republic to either Caprice, and then Caprice to Cabana.
Yeah.
And then Cabana to, I think, Venue or something like that. Like, those were the joints back in the day, and then that's when the newer, nicer clubs started to pop off. Like you know, the clubs out in Yale Town.
Yeah.
And then, like, Dre's, and then... what's the Pierre's and stuff like that? The nicer, like, I guess, bougier lounge.
Yeah, yeah. But like there's a more dress code to it.
Yeah. So my move mainly, and this was just, this is my club moves.
Yeah.
Right. This is way different from what I actually do now, which I don't fucking go to clubs anymore or any of that shit anyways. Nope.
But I'm too fucking old now.
Yeah. Fucking, I have a different process of how, we'll actually touch up on both of them. But my process with club was actually very simple. It's very short. Number one, buy a girl the drink, right?
Yeah.
Well, before you do that, you don't just like, here's a drink, I ain't on. You know, you don't just fucking.
No, you'll get slapped and the here's drink will probably get dumped on you.
First of all, fucking if you do that, they're going to think that you roofied it if you just bring
100%.
Them like, here's a cranberry vodka.
Drink it.
Usually what my move was is like, so my buddies, we would always like we would grab a hotel or something like for all of us to stay or something like that. And then after that, there would always be like another group of girls that were going, but they'd stay in a different hotel, but we would all talk like we would, you know? Yeah. So the thing is like, you relay that, you know, you talk and make sure that, you know, like it's your group and their group kind of a thing.
Yeah.
But most of the times, it was like, okay, this guy gets that girl gets that guy. It's like that. So
like it's like an energy thing. Like everybody kind of feels.
But there's always that one person that doesn't
there's
have.
There's no pair.
Yeah, there's no pair. That's where you like, right?
Yeah.
And of course, depending on the looks and how she presents herself that night, that will make the decision whether if I will go for her or not, right? So usually what I did, I'll use this as an example. This was like way back, probably just a little bit after high school. Exact same scenario that I just explained. One girl that was in the friends group, but like wasn't really kind of had like a different vibe. Not like it was bad or she was awkward, but just like she was very different from all the other girls, right?
Okay.
And immediately, usually like I think just like instinctively wise, like people are usually attracted to someone that is like unique in their own way. Yeah. Not in the way like there's one person that's super loud or something like that. Oh, like that's unique. That's just fucking annoying.
That's
like,
just actually.
Don't be that one friend, bro. Don't be that friend that is so fucking loud and no one can stand you. Don't be that friend. Right. Yeah. But there's always that one girl that's like a little bit more unique, you know, a little bit more like she looks like she has an intellectual side, right?
Right.
So my way of usually getting with those people is by usually roasting the group that I'm with and then roasting the group that she's with, right? Because you know that they're like, she's like not about it. Mm-hmm. Well, not about like she's friends with them, but like
she's just not as engaged in the conversation.
She doesn't carry herself the same way they do. Yeah. You know what I mean? So usually, and this actually kind of like is very similar to the way that I kind of have dates now. But usually, I'll go to like a choir. We'll talk and you know, we'll make jokes. I usually always humor is the number one thing. Humor is the number one thing, right?
Yeah,
because like. I was also, I was in the club scene, but like 9 times out of 10, if I wasn't pissed drunk, I'm not usually enjoying it. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? Because usually back then the DJs were shit. They just played mainstream music like DJ Khaled or whatever the fuck, you know,
just started like from the bottom. Overplayed hype music.
Yeah, overplayed hype like, music, right? And it's just like you weren't about it, right?
Yeah.
So like, you know, I would talk to the girl a little bit and then go to like a quieter part. The nice part was Caprice. It had like a second level, you know, that second level.
Yeah, that.
So I would take them up to the second level, and then that's where I would have like a little bit more of a cooler conversation. Like, oh, so you know,
yeah, you have a drink and you can actually have a real calm.
And this is what I like to do. This is actually my favorite thing to do because, dude, the whole entire Granville Strip, there's so much shit to do. Like people don't know, but there's places are still kind of open to eat and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
So like I would take the girl up, like we would talk and I was like, yo, like do you want to just like. Fucking can it. Like can this place.
Yeah.
You know? And she's like, yeah. And then but I would never say like, hey, do you want to go back to my hotel?
The cheesy fucking
hey, let's get out of here. You know? Like the good old fucking,
come on back to my place.
It would be like, yo, let's I would be like, yo, I want to go grab some pizza. Are you down?
Yeah.
And she's like, yeah, fuck yeah. And then we go grab that megabyte. Is it megabyte pizza? It's called Megabyte, right?
I can never read the fucking sign. I'm normally too fucked up, and I'm just like,
well, yeah, that I'm place usually, looks fucking I'm good. Usually pretty that buzzed
Donair
too.
Strip?
Oh, my God. Bro. Yo, it was either between the pizza strip or the Donair strip.
Yeah.
That would take them to, right?
I fucked that up.
And I would take them one of the two, and then we just, like, we literally just grab, like, pizza or whatever, and we just walk down Granville, man, just looking at all the other drunk people, and we just chill.
Yeah.
Right. And that's usually how I picked up the girl. And that was like the process. It turned something that was a club scene and like vibe and get drinks, have a fun time for a little bit.
Yeah.
But then after that, it's just like, okay, gotta find a kill.
Mm-hmm.
And then you look at it and then I take it the completely different route. I almost turn it into like a date.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Cause like it's usually like, yeah, girls like to have fun, but like, I'm not that guy that will like go to the club and like fucking make out with some chick on the dance floor, blah, 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 you know, like I'm not trashy like that. I don't think I've ever like my whole entire life, like going down to the
club.
I've never been
sloppy or
like,
anything.
If a girl will dance with me and like she'll ground me, whatever, bet, like go for it. But like, I'm never that scene, like just like, oh,
I'm not trying to get fucking dome in the club or anything.
I mean,
like
I don't know. I know a few buddies that have.
It's fine if you do. Like,
I know a few buddies that have gotten dome on the dance floor, like in the bathroom.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure actually there was a bathroom that, which one was it? It was Aura, bro. You remember Aura?
I do remember it. I think I've only been there.
I've like heard that club has had a bunch of, like, I don't know if it's still open, but I remember once, I don't know if actually it always happens, but I remember one sitch where I was going to the bathroom and like it was stalls and there's a security guard there. I don't know how the security guard didn't see this, but like one stall open and literally a dude and a girl came out. I'm like, all right, I know exactly what happened in there.
Well, like a lot of the time too, like this is like another, like if you're one of those people who likes to hook up in bathrooms or whatever, or wants to hook up in bathrooms, like you can just slip like a 20 to the bouncer who's like around there and just like, he'll know the deal, right? Like you're either going in there for drugs or you're going in there to fuck. So it's like little.
Really?
Little, yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, you just do like a little exchange of some money and then like they get it, right?
The dirt scene, man. The dirt scene.
Of them probably like will take the money and then they'll just be like, all right, fuck this guy. I'm watching him. Like,
yeah.
You know, like I know there's probably some that are, you know, not about it, but.
Yeah. But like to that point, it's kind of how I do dates now. Like usually the first date, I'm not even trying to like, sex isn't exactly the first thing that's on my mind. It's never usually, again, everyone's very well aware of this. I'm not. Mm-hmm. Type of guy that's just like out there just fucking put my penis in everything, right? Like same. I'm very like, take a girl on a date, take you on a date,
you want to establish dates. Something
yeah real. Establish something unless I make it noted to that girl like, yo, I just want to smash,
yeah,
then we make it, then there's not even a date, it's just like you just come over and that's
it's just a session.
It's literally just a sesh. Like a little quick little 40-30 minute sesh, just that's it, and just get it out of there.
Little two minutes, just us.
But no, that's how I translate, like how I go on dates now. Like it's very like first date, you know, take him. It's usually obviously dinner or something like that. But like I like keeping it like a little bit more fun, you know, take him out on, you know, I don't know, going for a walk somewhere, going for a bike ride. I usually like going for walks. Walks are nice. Walks are really nice.
Because you can actually talk. Like a bike ride would be kind of like difficult. Like I know how to ride a bike, but like.
Well, you don't have like, to talk, right?
Pedaling and you're just like, catch me, catch me.
Well, like you don't have to talk in the bike ride, but you can just go along the fucking like, you know, the
just
route.
Just to spend time.
Yeah, just to spend some time, right? Like I think obviously the first day should definitely be like dinner. And something like that. Have like some ground of communication, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Movies, I've tried movies on the first date. It's like cool. However, like if the drive to the movie theaters is like very short, then it can get awkward because you haven't even talked to the girl, right? Or the person. So like I would definitely like suggest dinner first and then maybe movie second. I don't know why people don't like going to movies anymore.
Movies are sick, but like you have to have like an actual like relationship kind of forming, and that's kind of like why like I'm a bit of a cheap fuck sometimes, so it's like I don't go to dinner first normally. Like normally I'll do something that's more like a free option, like the walking or like a cheaper thing, like where you can just go and like hang out somewhere and just kind of chill, like something really casual. And then like if I'm like, okay, this is somebody who I'd actually like to see, I'll invest the whatever fucking $100 or whatever to go and have dinner, have a fucking sick time, and like show this person that like, all right, like I'm fine spending some money.
Would you
this.
Take a girl on a hike?
Yes.
Because I feel like that's a terrible idea.
I have enough confidence in my cardio level that like I think that it would be
it depends
fine.
On one hike.
Sorry?
It depends on what hike. If you're doing abby grind, then like no. Because like the thing is like you're trying almost trying to like have a conversation, take a steadier pace, but you're just like, oh
yeah.
How's the weather?
I guess it depends on like the angle that you've got. Like if you're just about like let's go get the view, hang out a little bit up there, and then like we've got some plans for like after or whatever, or like the drive is where we're really gonna like have a conversation and like chat, then that's cool. But like yeah, if you're like yeah dude, I'm gonna put all my groundwork in the hike and then we're gonna go and smash after, it's like no dude, you guys are gonna both fucking
sweaty,
smell like shit, you're not gonna get any conversation done while you're trying to hike.
So what hobbies do you
like, bro, no, get the fuck out of here.
Well, like here's the thing, if you take a girl on the hike, actually now that I think about it, I take back what I said. If you do the hike and then you finish the hike, but you're chilling at that peak, then that's where you can actually like chill, hang out, talk, you know, bring some snacks, you know, bring a little charcuterie board, just like, you know,
abby grind, just people like in charcuterie boards, some fucking champagne,
right? That'd be the biggest flex. Like just like in your backpack. Oh, what do you got in backpack? Oh, nothing. Just like a cutting board sticking out.
And then got like this fine like diamond chess table that you're just like
yeah, let's play some and let's like
we'll spend the super, evening
super hipster. Actually, you know what I think about it, like if you were to go on the have you heard of the hike in North Van, Quarry Rock?
No.
Deep Cove hike.
I've heard Deep Cove.
It's super easy. It is like, it's not even a hike, bro. It's like just easy as fuck. Like it's the easiest.
It's like a steep walk.
Yeah, it's okay. Literally like a steep walk. Like you're not fucking like, you know, you're not stepping up. Yeah. And the viewpoint is beautiful, man. It's super, super nice. Because you see like this little, like cute little, you know, little valley with houses and water's very, very clear. So like now that I think about it, yeah, taking a hike and then you can have like, a little bit of a chit chat. I don't know. I don't know exactly what you do for first dates. I'm not saying that you're not sophisticated, but like I like a more sophisticated like night.
Mm-hmm.
So like I like, you know, a nice steak dinner or like whatever the fuck.
And yeah, no, I like that's the thing. Like I'm definitely like, I'm not going to pursue something with somebody unless I know that they're on the same vibe as me. Like if we can like, have a sophisticated conversation, we can actually get in deep and have like a real conversation where we're talking about real life shit and, you know, whatever our future intentions with each other and shit like that, then totally like I'm down for that. But I, cause I've been in the situation where I've done the dinner first.
Yeah.
And then you're like, you are a dead human being. Like you no offer fucking nothing. Like, and that's not to be shallow or mean or anything, but like some people just aren't, they're not ready to open up to somebody right off the bat or, and that's totally fine. So it's kind of like you have to, for me at least, I like to put in some kind of groundwork, establish where we both stand and, you know, who this person is. Are we going to be compatible to some degree if that's what I'm looking for? And then go to dinner because I know that, like, you know what? This is not going to be just a waste of my time and money. This is something that is, you know, a worthwhile investment.
So what initially intrigues you into that person? Like what are the main attributes that like, okay, like she seems like a good person, you know, I'm down to go on a date with you. Like what are the key things? Like do you have to have the same interest? Like does it or is it like do you have to have the same values online? I'm like, there's obviously only so little that you can learn about someone over social media.
Definitely.
You know what I mean? Or texting or whatever that communication, that form of communication I should say instead. You know, like what are the main things for you that like all right, like I'm actually willing to take you on a date now at this point, because like you seem like you've hit all those, like do you have a little bit of a checklist when it comes to like that, or just like it's just based off the conversation that you have with the person?
I wouldn't really call it a checklist because I'm not like, you know,
well I'm just using something as an
example. Definitely, but I don't really have like anything that I'm, you know, specifically looking for in any type of person. But for me anyway, like we have to get along, obviously. Like we have to how do I word it?
Like you, the same energy, same vibe.
Yeah, you have to have, you know, a similar kind of energy. You have to be, you know, a
on the same
some kind of a heartfelt person. Yeah, you have to have like a care for people. You have to be able to engage in a conversation and be ready to actually converse.
Yeah.
Somebody who's funny as well. Like, cause I've talked to people who just, they're super serious. They're super just full of themselves. Yeah. People who have a huge ego too, turn me the fuck off, dude. Yeah. Like, I'm not about, you think you're hot shit because you got your fucking nails done, your lips done, your hair done. Like, fucking, I'll pull those fucking eyelashes off and, you know, show you who the fuck you are. Like, just don't bring that shit to the table.
It's not, for me, natural beauty is like, facts. Probably the most appealing
girls who
thing.
Don't wear makeup and are confident with it. Like, I don't care. Like, even if you do think like, oh, I'm not attractive, or I would be way more attractive with makeup. Like, trust me. Like, if you come with confidence,
trust me.
That shit's hot as fuck.
Like, dude, and we're not trying to say any bad shit about girls that wear makeup. Like, makeup's fine.
No, definitely.
Because like, fucking bro, like, makeup can do wonders. It can make you look like a different person.
Yeah.
But like, the thing is, like, if you're like wear makeup to the gym and shit
all the time, yeah, if you literally, you know, like, build your ego based on your makeup and you just have this whole extra lifestyle, because yeah, like, there's people who you literally go out with and you see her with makeup and she's like, oh damn, okay, she's, you know, she's fine, and then somehow you see her with her friends after like a fucking sleepover or something and she's like just naked, like, face, and you're like, what the fuck? Who is that? Who's your friend? It's like, no, that's so and so. It's like, no, it's not. I saw her yesterday.
She
it's
was wearing a mask.
She was wearing a mask.
Fucking yeah. Like,
yeah, chicks that overdo it and then like you.
So that's not.
You hype nuts. Yourself up over it and like, yeah, don't do that shit.
Yeah, man. Like,
that's a no go for me.
Here's the thing, right? And I know I'm going to get shit on this and I don't give a fuck because this podcast is raw and unfiltered.
And it's your personal opinion, so you're entitled to that.
Yeah. But like, you know, of course a girl that flexes on the gram, like, you know, you flash, you know, show a little bit of cleavage and like, you know, I, to be completely honest, I'm a tits guy. So like, as soon as I see a pair of fucking nice, like a nice, I simp.
Yeah. I'm an ass man. Yeah, so I'll go the other way with that.
But like, for me, like, here's the thing. When you show that out, like, I get it, whatever. Feel yourself out. Like, if you flaunt it, if you got it, flaunt it.
Yeah.
You know, fucking use what God gave you.
Yeah.
You
know what I mean? Enjoy it, man.
But like, here's the thing. We're guys. We have dicks and we want to put them inside of things. Simple. So if we see you flexing on the gram with like a bunch of makeup, you know, your tits out, your ass, your fucking this and that. Like, I get it, you're feeling yourself, but like, just remember you're attracting like those guys that are idiots and just want to put their dicks in things.
That's facts.
So like, and bro, I fucking hate it. I hate it when girls post on their stories on their Instagram, like, oh my God, look what this guy said. Oh my God, look what this guy
when
said.
When chicks like, roast stop, like, the shit out of guys like, and like what, screenshot like the messages you, of like, hey, like, want to hook or whatever. Like, they're just looking at low level shit.
Yeah, and then they're being roasting like, oh my God, it. Like, this guy is so like, dude.
It's like, your story was you in a fucking bikini with your fucking nipples hanging out. Like, sorry, what kind of attention were you looking for? Did you want like some guy to come and take you out on a date?
Yeah, like,
I think.
What? No, it's not 19. 30 minutes.
Oh, I didn't even see it.
Yeah, sorry. It's, but like, I get it, bro. I get it. You know, you got a nice bikini and everything like that, and you want to flex. It's the same thing as a guy, you know, having a muscle teen, like, you know.
Yeah, it's the same.
Showing a little flex, but like, remember, it's like you're kind of attracting like that same person, right? Of a fucking guy with his shirt off, you know, is flexing on the gram. What do you think that's going to attract? It's going to attract the girls that are like, yo, like, that's, you know, stuff,
bro,
like that.
I specifically post, like, shirtless pics or whatever just because I'm feeling myself and like I know for like, you know, and here's the thing, like, currently I'm not looking for like any like wild hookups or anything like that. Like, I'm cool with it, but knowing that like I'm gonna get a couple messages from, you know, little heart eyes or,
well,
little,
you obviously
flame emojis or shit like that, it's just like, you know, it's cool, it's a nice little ego boost, but I'm not gonna pursue you, I'm not gonna, you know.
Yeah, but of course you're putting it out there for a specific reason. You want
the attention.
You want them girls to be attention. Like, oh shit, like,
oh my
six
God.
Pack. But like, But like
DJ Diddle. Era. Sorry.
Era.
Oh my god.
But no, like for girls. Okay. For girls. Fuck, hold on. I'm trying not to.
Jesus, ground yourself. Christ.
I just think about it, it just gets funny. So for girls, like, I don't know, man. It's just like, just remember, like, don't be fucking appalled or like repulsed that like you're getting these messages from these guys if you're like showing your ass and like you got a little bit of nipple poking out. Mm-hmm. Like I get it, the whole free the nipple thing. Like whatever, I don't give a fuck. If you want to wear a bra, don't wear a bra. I'm not against whatever you're doing, mm-hmm. right? I'm not gonna be like, oh my god, take your picture down. It's so sexual. It's so like revealing. I don't give a fuck. Post whatever you want to.
Yeah.
You want to fucking show your asshole on the fucking gram? Go for it. I don't care. But like, don't be fucking like amazed or surprised that like you're getting all these like simp messages from these guys because you're posting, like
you posted it for attention one way or another. Like people post pictures like that or body pictures like that because they're feeling themselves and they want some kind of attention for it. They want somebody to talk about it or show them that, like reinforce the idea that they're hot. That's totally fine.
But
like exactly like you said, like don't get fucking angry, like to a degree. Like there's some guys who take it far, they'll send their dick pics and whatever like that. Sure, roast those dudes that are fucking weird and creepy. But if some dude is just legitimately like just seeing if you want to hook up because that's the kind of image that you're giving off, don't get all fucking like you know.
And you know what, I'm actually trying to play on like a girl side of it.
Yeah, because you know? Like I can see the point too, and I can see how irritating it would be to get, you know, simp messages all the time and all day.
And you know what, it isn't fair because like a lot, again, guys have dicks and they want to put them in things. Mm-hmm. And it is not fair. It's not fair that you guys get a bunch of messages, but like, and but unfortunately that's just guys and that's the world we live in. You know, you can't just be against all guys. Like, oh, why do all guys have to be like this? Well, your tits are on the fucking ground, bro. Like you're wearing a bunch of makeup, you know. You're giving that little fucking angle where you're popping, you're pushing. Oh, we know what the fucking move is. We're bodybuilder. We know how this shit works.
We know angles.
You push, you squeeze the left glute and then you pop out the hip and then the right cheek just is fucking just like right there.
You tilt your body.
Get the
waist looking nice and tight.
We know the move. Like it's just like you tilt your body. Your waist is like super slim. You fucking clench the left cheek and you pop your right ass out, and she's like, and then you take the phone, you cover half your face with it, right? Because you know, obviously when you're doing that pose, your face is not pretty, you know. You're just like,
you just got like the lips, you just got like that.
Yeah, so you gotta like put the phone. Hold on, where's my phone? You gotta like put the phone in front of you like this, and you just be like, just finish the gym. Like this is literally every, like this is like, I don't know one girl that hasn't hit this pose. You know, they're just like.
That's literally, that's like the staple, like, you know.
Used to be the gym. Duck lips, but now the move is the 2020 hip-hop.
The hip-hop, showing off the wop.
But you know what? You hit the gym, you feel good, you got a nice glute pump, you want to show it off, go for it. But like, just remember, you're going to get attacked by some of those simps. The simps are out there. Fucking, unfortunately, I'll hate to admit it, sometimes I'm one of them. But it's usually on the premise of like not an ass, but like usually more like if I see fucking a nice pair of fucking Mels. I try to make Mels. It sound so cool, but Mellies. It sounded so fucking
weird. YNW Mels.
But it's just like, just something about that, you know?
Yeah.
But like nine times, I'm not gonna comment like, oh my god.
Oh my god, baby, you so sexy. You fuck marry me, please.
You want fuck?
Hey, baby, you want fuck?
But no, I'll just be like, you know, I'll either react with the fire.
Yeah.
The fire, like, reaction.
Yeah.
Or the clap one. Yeah, actually, the clap one's more for, like, I use that reaction for, like.
Good job.
Not a good job, but, like, whenever I see something that's, like, I see someone post one of those, like, posts that's just, like, kind of, like, like it's spitting facts. I'll just do like one of those.
Yeah,
bet, bro. Like one of those.
Big bet.
The fire one I use a little bit more because the fire one is more like the hard eyes one is kind of creepy. And the hard eyes one you only use for like if you're really seeing that person. You know what I mean? Like if you're really seeing that person, then you use the hard eye reaction.
I like the hard eyes pose, but like I usually think that I'm more on the flames.
On the flame. It's a little bit more subtle, but like that you know what you're getting. Your point is clear. Your point is clear.
Yeah.
And then that's when they give the like, oh, thanks, or like, oh, thanks. And that's when you're like, DM.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But like,
slide.
But on other terms, like we said again, you're going to get those DMs.
Yeah.
And it's fine. But, well, it's actually not fine. But it's
like,
just like,
don't blow it out of proportion. Like, if you're just getting messages from fucking dudes that are simping, just let it go. Just, let it, whatever, feed your ego, whatever you need it to do, and just put it away. Just bury it. Like, you don't need to respond. You don't need to talk about them. You don't need to talk to them. Just forget about it.
Yeah. Please stop trying to flex as if, like, a bunch of guys DM you and there's such thirsty messages. Like, 9 times out of 10, that guy's probably from, like, Ukraine, fucking Pakistan, right? Saying, like, oh, my God. Yeah. Or, like, maybe, who knows? Maybe it is someone that's local, but, like, if I see that shit and like you're just like, oh my God, look at this guy, that's so fucking upset. Like that actually is the biggest turnoff to me if I see a girl post that shit.
It shows how insecure you are.
Yeah, it's almost like you're showing
how much you're desperate for attention.
Like you don't see guys doing that.
No.
You know? Like it's like so like.
Like there are definitely some dudes that are just like, oh, look at the fucking hot bitch that's in my DM, bro. Like it's like, okay, cool. Like that's like you can talk about that amongst your friends, but you don't need to like post shit like that, like, you know.
Yeah,
and
I will agree, girls get the mass majority of those simp messages. Like guys don't get simp messages. It just doesn't work that way, right? But you know, it's just like, don't fucking, you know, like if the guy's being like, you know, like I don't know, if he's being like threatening or he's being annoying
or if he's legitimately harassing you,
you know what, there's such a thing, it's called block.
Yeah,
it's that simple. Don't need a fucking talk about them or blast them on your story. It's not necessary. Just block them, bro.
Yeah.
Like, don't. Why are you investing so much energy into this thing?
Yeah.
Posting them on your story.
Redirect
like,
your energy.
Posting them on the story. Like, oh my God, you can't just like we're arguing about the stupid. Just block him, bro. Like, just block him. It's that simple.
Yeah. You don't need to feed into it.
Yeah. Like it's social media at the end of the day. Like, who gives a fuck, bro? You know. Yeah. It's just so like, yeah. I don't know. I actually now to kind of hop back on track here. I would much rather actually prefer a girl that like is not so like invested with social media, like is a little bit more low key with social media, because like my job and what I do, like I said again, it's very social media oriented. So I would prefer someone that actually doesn't
have a break from that.
Yeah, and like it's just, it kind of shows that like they don't, you know, social media is cool to like send like TikToks and shit like that. Like it's like that's what I like doing. I like sending TikToks, sending memes and shit like that. But like I don't, you know, like if your whole entire thing is like, I want my feed to look like this, I want to flex this, I want to flex that. Like
if it's literally just nothing but like
trying to get a clout chaser,
your tits or like Gucci Louis bags. Sorry, it's not it.
Yeah, you're not it, bro. You're not it. I don't know. For me and you, I think we like more of like those genuine, just like likes going out, likes and likes actual social life. Outside of social media, like they like social, like they like doing fun things, like they like doing like going on hikes, going for coffee, going for that. Like they don't spend as much time on their phone.
Yeah, I'm more of a low key guy. Like I'm low key, like social, like I'm socially awkward at times, and like I've battled anxiety and shit like that before, and obviously still do, but I'm a little bit more reserved. I'm more of a homebody. I'm more the type of guy who, I like to just stay at home and chill. I don't really like huge crowds or you know, super.
I force them to come out to those. Yeah, things.
Literally. So it's like the girls who I'm normally vibe with aren't like super eccentric. Those usually we don't, you know, have like a huge connection. Like it's fun. I've got friends that are, you know, very bubbly personality and, you know, very talkative and stuff like that, which is awesome. But I'm more of like if we can chill and like whatever, just fucking play Mario Kart or something at home, have some snacks and just chill, that's super cool to me. Yeah. Like I like that vibe. Facts. But somebody who's just a real person, like if we can have a conversation, it doesn't just revolve around materialistic stuff. We can have a conversation that talks about our life, our past, our goals. We can talk about our feelings, like shit like that, where there's no judgment. There's openness. You're not talking shit on, you know, fucking everybody in your life or just blaming people for your problems and shit like that. We'll have a good time. Yeah. We'll have a good time.
Big facts. Just be genuine, man. Like it's the most, I think this is the most appealing thing for a lot of people nowadays. It's just being like actually just so real, bro.
Yeah.
You know, like, and I
ugly or not, like if you fucking hate where you're at, like being honest with it, you know, like just talking about, you know, this is just me. This is my life. Yeah.
You
right?
don't, and like, I'd much rather hear someone say like, you know what? My life's kind of in the gutters right now, but I'm trying to figure my shit out. I'd much rather hear that than be like, oh yeah, you know, I do this for like that. And like, you know, things are a little bit tough. And like,
positivity, know, baby. Like, yeah. Just
it's okay, fuck, bro. Like, dude, you don't always.
Life isn't always good, man. Life sucks sometimes. Yeah. And just like understanding that like there's good times and there's not so good times, but just, you know, riding it out, just fucking making it through to seeing the good days, right?
Yeah. Like, it's what matters. I'd much rather hear that than someone be like, you're like trying to flex, like, oh, you know, am I buying a new car? Am I getting a new job? Am I might do this. Am I might do that. It shows, like, when I see that from hopping from one person, from hopping from thing to thing, it shows that you're just kind of run away from shit.
Yeah. You know, you're, I mean? Yeah, you're using it to hide behind, you know, hide behind your real issues.
Yeah. And like, if I knew that you had like a boyfriend like 6 months ago and you're already like, I don't know, you know, dating's fine, whatever. Yeah. But like, you're already trying to get cuffed up again. Yeah. And you're just like, yeah,
you struggle with being alone. And like, I mean, yeah, no, like nobody likes to be alone, but that's a really important skill that I've like literally just learned how to establish, is like being alone and being okay with just being in your own presence. Right. Like,
contentment with solitaire, man.
That's facts.
But like, yeah, it's just like, just be genuine, bro. Like, it's going to attract. This goes for both girls and guys. Just be you, who you are. Be genuine. Be as you as you possibly can be. And and here's the thing that I actually was, I think, listening to on a podcast, or I forgot what his name is, man. But he said that this is what he did to find his like wife or his significant other.
Yeah.
No. This is different, right? Dating is different than being with significant other. Dating is to kind of, I guess, find that person. But this is what his process was to find like his significant other. He's like, so what I did, this is his words. He's like, what I did is I wrote down exactly what I wanted my future wife or my significant other to be. And he's like, I ended up writing 4 full pages of details and notes of how specific I wanted it to be, down to the hair, down to the eyes, the facial structure, everything, that exact, all the way down to the very slimmest detail. And when I thought about if I wrote enough about how specific I wanted that person to be, I ended up writing another 4 pages of that person.
Holy shit.
And then what he did is he looked at it and he was like, okay, now how do I become the person for that person? And that's the biggest thing, bro. It's not like, you know, you can't just find that, you know, we said this in the last podcast before, you're not going to find your Prince Charming or your princess, like, just by dating a bunch of other people, which, who knows, maybe you do, right?
Yeah, but that's more through luck. If you just stumble upon them, if you've got an intent to be with the person that you want to spend the rest of your life with, you need to be the type of person capable of having that person in your life.
Exactly.
Like, you can't just continue to be the same, you know, like I used to be a you know, fucking kind of lower level, like just kind of like a, you know, a piece of shit. I was, you know, less involved, didn't want to talk about my feelings, didn't want to have communication. It was just kind of like, you know, whatever, sex is cool. But developing into a person where you value having somebody that you can confide in, to, you know, to actually achieve your goals, vice versa. You want to help them achieve theirs. And like, you, you're looking for that soulmate, if you will, like that cheesy fucking term, but
no, but like it's correct, man. Like, you got to bring in that energy that you want for your significant others, but you got to be that person. You can't ask for something that is so amazing, but you don't have the abilities to like harness like that relationship or that person, because you yourself are not ready.
Yeah,
it's kind of just like
you can't love somebody unless you love yourself. Well, like similar to that kind of mentality. You know what I'm saying?
It's not even that. I don't think it's that mentality. It's more so you're not ready for that person because you haven't grown to the person you need to be yet.
Yeah, right. But okay, so like somebody kind of laid it out like for me like this, and it made a lot of sense. I was bitching and complaining about my car at the time, right? Mm-hmm. And I was like, fuck, like, my car's a piece of shit. Like, I hate it. I want a brand new car. I want to go buy, like, this fucking brand new expensive car. That's what I want. Mm-hmm. And then they were like, okay, well, why are you unhappy with it? Like, why is it a piece of shit? And I was like, well, all this is going on, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, do you take care of it? Like, do you clean it? What does it look like? And I'm like, fuck, okay. He's like, you don't value what you have right now.
Yeah.
So how do you expect to value what you get? Like, everybody gets something new, and if they don't know how to treat it properly, it just ends up shitty like all their other stuff, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's like, if you need to learn how to take care of that car, how to, you know, fix it when it's broken, how to clean it, how to care for it properly, mm-hmm. in order to get, mm-hmm. you know, something that you really fucking want.
Yeah, exactly. And then maybe later down the future, then you outgrow that car, and you find something better because you outgrow it, right?
Yeah.
It's, and to that back to that same concept, it's just kind of like this, right? Let's say you're a new beginner in photography, right? What you should do is start off with a cheaper camera, $200, $300 camera. But if someone ends up handing you, like, say, like, you get lucky, right? And you win this $10,000 camera, like a fucking sick camera, and you're just getting into photography. Do you think you're going to be able to utilize or use that camera to its fullest capabilities? You're not going to be ready for that. Not for a few years.
You're not
going to
understand all even the capabilities by, of
even
it,
by,
right?
Even by the time that you do learn about you, even by the, let's say you are a new beginner, right? And with that $10,000 camera, and then you end up using it and you finally learn about it. By the time you learn about it, something else is already going to come out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, something better is going to come out. So like, it's much better, you know, like, being able to just be good at what you are at with now, with what you have, like you were saying with the car, be good at what you are, take care of what you have, learn with what you have, and then you can kind of move on and be like that. So like, that's the same thing for like finding significant others. You could write down exactly who you want to be with, how perfect they have to be, their skin complexion, everything down to the last detail.
Right.
But 9 times out of 10, if not 10 times out of 10, you are not going to be ready for that person. The same way you won't be ready with that $10,000 camera that you get at that certain point in your life.
100%.
You know?
And so yeah, on the other side of that coin, like, once you've got that, you know, that dream manufactured person that you've made in your head, like, who exactly that is going to be, doing that for yourself, being like, okay, what person do I need to be? How do I need to develop myself to be able to have that in my life?
Yeah. And you will like, when you start to actually, you know, become that person for that person, like, you start to, you know, be, you know, work on yourself and become a more developed person, the energy of you doing that will ultimately attract that person. And like, me and Nick are both really big on energy and stuff like that, but like, it's ultimately like, you will end up actually attracting that person more and more the more you become the person that you want to be with.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You don't even have to, it will literally feel effortless. Like, you will attract that person that you were supposed to be with because of the person you are becoming.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to go out and look for them, right? It's, and that's why, like, with the whole dating thing, like, I agree with it. Like, you know, you should get out there and, like, you know, see, you know, how different people are in different situations, all the other people out there, but ultimately
don't have regrets. Like, go and experience things and go and, you know, hang out with different people, go and do your thing, just enjoy your life. Don't make sure that, you know, when you die, you don't have any regrets, you know, that you didn't do something or you didn't go out and, you know, date somebody or whatever. Yeah. Right.
But also, don't spend your whole entire life dating a bunch of people expecting that one person is gonna be the perfect person, because that's honestly, like, it's such a old school way of thinking about how to find your like significant other nowadays.
Yeah.
Because usually nine times out of ten, like a fucking...
You're like a fucking IGN video game score review.
Yeah, fuck. But like usually, like out of most cases that like all my friends that are in long-term relationships, they never met them. They're just dating. Yeah. They met them super organically, like at a party or at this or at that. And they've been together ever since.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like they went on fucking Plenty of Fish or Tinder and it's like, oh, I'm married to you. Like sometimes it works, you know, whatever. It's fluke.
Yeah.
Or maybe they're just stuck in lust the whole entire time. I don't fucking know. But like, you know, it's just like you, it's, I'm so like, and you know what? You can call me stubborn or whatever, but I'm very sold on the fact that you will attract that person when you're ready to.
Right.
There is someone out there for you, but you got to be the right person for it.
That's and like that's
you can't be thinking about it too. You can't be thinking like, oh, am I ready yet? Am I ready yet?
Yeah.
It just happens when you actually focus on yourself and like they just come towards you. They just present yourself and they present themselves in your life at that time when you are ready without even having to think about it.
Exactly. I found myself getting like frustrated a lot of the time. Like, and I'm sure like you've had it too. Like where you're like, fuck, man. Like I keep on like, I'll get in a relationship and it just doesn't fucking work. Like,
yeah.
Am I ever going to find that person? Like, this is so frustrating. I'm getting older, but like, am I ever going to meet that person that I'm going to spend the rest of my life with? And it's like going back and just like having that faith that that person is there and it's going to happen. You just need to keep on putting the work in with yourself.
Yeah.
And it'll come. Just stop fucking, you know, having that as your sole focus,
yeah,
and get your mind off of it, and then, like you said, organically, that person will, you know, work their way into your life, and energy will do the rest. Energy will do the rest of the thing. Yeah. If it's supposed to happen, it's gonna fucking happen.
Yeah, exactly. And like that's why like I'm not against someone meeting their significant other on like a dating app or through social media. Like I'm not against it. Like maybe you can, but like I said.
Your wife is most likely not on Tinder.
Yeah. But like the thing is like, again, when you kind of get that through social media, and like I've had most of my relationships, unfortunately, start through social media, but like it kind of, you present yourself in a different image on social media. It's very different.
That's facts.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Whereas you meet that person organically, it's different because you only see one side of them now, right?
Mm-hmm.
You see that organic side of where you met them at. That person's party or that person's birthday
it's a really
party
good
or
point.
That bar.
You it's know, a really good
you
point.
See them only on one light, right? Whereas you look, which is their true genuine light. Whereas if you see them on social media, like, oh, they must be so like this because of all the shit they post.
Then yeah.
You meet them in person, they're just vanilla.
Yeah, you're like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Your Instagram says all this about you, but
it
you're
does,
that.
It gives you, it doesn't give you false hope because when you actually meet that person, when you actually see that person in like face to face, it's and you never saw their social media, like, fuck, this person's actually dope.
Yeah.
You know, you don't put a false, like,
there's no filter in real life.
Yeah. Facts. But yeah, I mean, to kind of wrap things up, you know, fucking weird. It's been the year has, maybe it's cuffing season, isn't it? It's coming close to cuffing
season. Feels like it might be.
I don't know if I'm ready for that. I don't know if I want to be cuffed in this situation, the world that we're living in right now.
Might need it though. Might be the best thing.
I don't think I need it. I mean, I wouldn't mind spending a nice evening in front of the fireplace, roasting some marshmallows, looking at the snowfall. So
I wouldn't mind a nice cup of cocoa under a warm, fuzzy blanket, you know, having little footsie rub with somebody.
That was weird.
Do you want to get together this
that was
winter?
Weird. That was like some Jeffrey Epstein shit.
What the fuck? This is very innocent. This is very, it's not Jeffrey.
Oh, God. Well, I don't know, man. Like, end of the day, stop.
Touch my foot.
Please, no.
Calvin, stop. Touch my foot.
Stop.
Touch my foot. Please. Okay.
Yeah, man. You know what? Year's almost over. We don't know what the fuck's going to happen. Hang on. You know, you don't got to get cuffed. Relax. Stop posting your fucking tit pics, your fucking booty pics. Stop starting an OnlyFans. It's fine. Everything's gonna be fine.
Do it.
You know,
enjoy
just,
it. Make money. Just, get
just,
the bag.
We just gotta bundle up, hunker down, go through this one more phase of whatever the fuck we're going through, and it's all gonna be over. Things will be back to normal, and then everything will be okay. It's all good, guys. Summer's over. Winter is coming.
Fall is here.
What is it? Is that the thing in the Game of Thrones, Winter is Coming?
I've never watched it.
Oh yeah, neither of us have watched that.
One episode or half of an episode or something.
But yeah, guys, to wrap things up, you know, me and Nick wanna really hear what you guys want to hear. I know we kinda we've been going back and forth about a bunch of things, but ultimately, you know, we wanna hear what you guys want us to talk about. We kind of get a very split even vote when it comes to like the Senti and the embarrassing stuff.
It's kind of fun to do like a mix of them in episodes too.
It does feel nice to actually like, you know, not have a guest too, because we kind of have the table. Whenever we have a guest, it's a little bit more cluttered. If you guys liked the episode with Taylor where we're talking about training, we actually really enjoy that one. We barely touched the surface on training because we kind of just like talked a little bit of how we got into it, but
like we were saying, we can go way deeper with it and have a much more involved convo.
If you guys want Taylor back on the podcast and talk a little bit more on training, let us know in the comments down below.
Yeah, go comment on that video. Let us know your guys' thoughts.
Yeah. I don't know who the fuck, by the way, keeps up downvoting our shit. Whoever you are,
we got some haters out there, and that's
totally fine. That means we're growing.
We love you.
But yeah, guys, that's going to wrap up episode 10 of this podcast. Let us know if you like this podcast. Make sure you're following us on Instagram at Jabroni Podcast, on Twitter at Jabroni_podcast. I think that's what it is. YouTube.com/JabroniPodcast. We're on Spotify. We're on Apple Music. We're on every social platform for audio streaming now. So till then, thank you so much for tuning in.
Thanks, guys.
And we will see you in the next podcaster. Peace.